Don't be talking to nobody. I'm serious, the biggest hot in this house. Y'all roll the, well, except this one. Y'all roll the windows down, make sure they see it. Right as you can. I always built these in Burger King and across the road. So far I've been able to get across the road. So. And then I go straight and I cry and go straight to work. One stop block. Actually there's more than that yet. I usually go through traveling on the street. Got caught by it one time at the gas station. Thursday I won't have nowhere to park if she tells me to come in. I'll have to park in the back of the building. And that's Griffin's parking lot. Griffin Bug Exterminator. Walk through the gate and walk through the playground and walk in the office.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. Sorry, yes, ma'am.
Hope time you grow up to 18 you will learn your manners. You're 14. Start learning. Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am. Yes, sir. No, sir. Please, may I have this? Get your elbows off the table. I hope by your 18 you'll know that by then. I'm waking up, trying to get moving. I'm just sitting here waiting because Aunt Terry has a doctor's appointment at 11, so she's got to take me to work. So just sitting here waiting till 8:15 and then head out. It don't take me 5 minutes to get there. And usually I get there and I still have to sit in my car. I sit in my car till about 8:29 to get out of my car, go inside and plug in. I ain't going in and sitting in the chair and staring at everybody. I just sit in my car. I know you did, I appreciate it. What you doing today? Well, we don't call, oh, that's right, you're retired. Chris going with you? I thought he was up. Oh, today's, what's today? Wednesday. Oh, snap, today's Wednesday. I was thinking today was Tuesday. Gee. Oh, yeah. Yeah, because tomorrow I don't have to go to work till after I get out of my doctor's appointment. Well, I have to call her if she tells me to stay home, and I'll just stay home, but I'm going to wear my work clothes just in case. If she tells me to go home, I'll just go home and change clothes. Try to call you my lunch. If you don't answer, then I'll call you my job work. But be careful out there. Alright, I'll try. Love you always. You're welcome, and thank you for following me. Alright, I'll talk to Andrew. Alright. Love you always. Talk to you soon. Alright. Bye-bye. That's shocking.
What?
You didn't hear me on the phone.
I mean, I heard you, but I mean.
So why would you ask me what was shocking if you heard me on the phone? Why would it shock you if I tell you I'm on the phone?
That's not what shocked me.
What?
I asked you that because, I thought something had been said that you didn't say out loud.
I was talking out loud. I don't talk as loud as y'all do.
No, that's not what I was saying.
Before you get me upset and I have to go to work and take it out on the kids, will you make your point?
I just said, well, technically, that I'm saying, sometimes you repeat things out loud, so I didn't know if something had been said that you didn't repeat.
The only thing I said I repeat out loud is I love you always.
Not that.
What? What?
I'm saying that wasn't even what I'm talking about. I mean, you said you were shocked, and I didn't know what you were shocked about.
Start using your brain, Danielle. Will hardly calls in the morning before I go to work. This is shocking.
It is.
See? I have to think for you. Why couldn't you figure that out? Why did I have to tell you?
I said I knew it. You didn't really have to.
Then I kept asking you what's shocking, and you said because I said shock twice. I said then, what is the shocking part, Danielle? And you never said Will called. If you just said Will called, I would know what you were talking about. But I didn't know what you were talking about, sweetheart. Don't you need my book?
No, just the activity.
I'm just couldn't figure out what you were saying, what was wrong, like shock. If you knew what the shock part was, I figured you would. I was waiting for you to. What I was waiting for you, I was waiting for your answer to be Will Brenner calling.
Sorry, Mom.
But you never said that. You just kept saying because I said shock twice. Why would I say shock twice? If you know the answer.
I realize that now, I'm sorry.
But you did before. Right?
Yes.
Then why did you tell me you knew? Danielle, I'm asking you a question.
Because I thought I did.
Well, you stop getting angry before I get angry.
Mom, I'm not getting angry.
Put everything down and maybe you won't be frustrated and look at me. Because I see you gritting your teeth, and I told you if you grit your teeth again, I'm going to pop you. Because you don't grit your teeth at me.
I wasn't gritting my teeth at you. I'm getting...
Oh, you weren't, so I'm lying. I'm getting... God, forgive me for lying for telling my daughter she gritted her teeth.
No, I did, but not at you.
Well, you were looking at me.
No, I was looking at the phone because I'm trying to concentrate on what I was reading, but I don't understand what it meant.
You have all day. I'm asking for 2 minutes of your time. You have from now to 7 o'clock tonight. I'm just asking for 2 minutes of your time. If you didn't know what shock meant, then why did you say you knew what I was talking about? You knew what I was talking about.
I thought I did.
Danielle, who calls me in the morning? Nobody. Nobody calls me
Yes, that's shocking.
Okay. Then you should have figured that out. Without me telling you, you should be thinking on your own. If you still can't figure out, then just ask me. But most things you need to start thinking on your own. Figure it out. Figure a loophole. But, I mean, if you can't figure it out, go through the loophole and try to and go outside the box and figure it out. Guess. If you can't figure it out, guess.
Okay.
And I'll tell you yes or no. I just want to see you using your brain. If you see something in the kitchen or the den, anywhere today that's out of place, put it up.
Yes, ma'am, I will.
Well, you didn't yesterday. You kept looking all around the kitchen trying to figure out what I was talking about. And we were only talking about those paper plates, and you still looked around the kitchen. Only thing I wanted was right in the middle of the counter where it always goes. And when I told you the counter, you looked all around the kitchen trying to figure out what I was talking about. The only thing I was talking about was those paper plates. This morning, you couldn't figure out what was so shocking. You get me? I have been thinking for you for how long? 3 years? Longer? Well, when you were younger, I understood, but now you're getting older, and I'm not understanding why I'm having to think for you. Can't you think for yourself?
Yes, Mother.
No, you can't. Then if you can, then why for 3 years I've been thinking for you and me both? So prove me wrong and start thinking for yourself. I try to think for myself so I don't have to call you. When I can't figure it out, I call you. Same thing with you. If you can't figure it out, call me. Yes, I'm trying to wake up. I slept all night long, but I'm trying to wake up. Why was it so hard to find the Dancing with the Stars last night when you normally can find it?
I don't know. I don't think I'll have to try again today.
Huh?
I said I'll have to try again today.
When I get home, yeah. I'm not out of a race yet when I get off that bus today, so I can leave at 4. Tomorrow, I have no idea. If I go to work tomorrow, I have no idea what time I'm getting off. It could be 5, it could be 6. Jerky woke me up at 5 o'clock this morning. I looked at the clock and I said, go back to bed. He laid back down, I went back to sleep. In about 5, 10 minutes to 6, I mean, 5, 10 minutes to 5, I went and got up, used the bathroom, turned the fan off, used the bathroom, took my medicine. Well, my poopy medicine. Woke you up. You know the rest.
Yeah.
And if you get hot, it ain't gonna kill you, just get off your butt and turn the fan on. If I hear that you're hot when I get home and you ain't got the fan on, I'm gonna be like, why didn't you turn the fan on? And if you tell me, because I was busy, I'm late. You said you were lazy and didn't want to get up and turn the fan on. I can lay on my stomach, but I wrinkle my pants up. Because cavalry pants wrinkle it too easy. Blue jeans don't. enjoying the ride, but I'm gonna get these two big giant bills done first. Because I'm pretty sure David's got the money in the bank for now. And I haven't seen none of it to pay the bank off. And the Verizon. And the AT&T. I hear trains here. Once in a while I hear fire trucks, but at work I hear more fire trucks than I do anything. But the fire station's right diagonal doors, right across the street on Pate Town Road.
Yeah.
And it's fire department number 3. I don't know what it is. I've been on that bus every day and I still get confused who gets off where. And it's aggravating.
Not a bit.
Because half the time, the kids that get off at the trailers get off at the, right there in the base gate where I take care of Crystal's mom. But this is this neighbor. This is this project. And then you got projects right beside them. That's where Miss Crystal's mom.